Well, thanks for logging on for your Saturday morning tropical weather update. And we've got a lot of activity in the tropics that we're covering. In fact, three areas of concern. Let me start by taking you once again out to Hurricane Jose. If you were with me last week, we were talking about this storm making a loop-de-loop out in the Atlantic, and it in fact did that very thing. It's dealing with a little bit of westerly shear right now, and that's going to be the case over the course of today and tomorrow. And that shear should keep it from developing into anything stronger than what it currently is. It's probably going to get a little bit strong because it's moving out over some very warm water, but that westerly shear should keep it from growing in intensity more than 5 or 10 miles per hour. So we're going to follow that very close, and I'm going to show you the National Hurricane Center forecast track on Jose in just a moment. We also have this potential cyclone that is out in the Atlantic as well, several hundred miles to the east of the Windward and the Leeward Islands on that westerly course at 22 miles per hour. So it's moving out at a pretty good clip. Got a little bit of dry air it's going to be dealing with, but definitely 100% chance of that developing into a tropical storm. And of course, we now have Tropical Storm Lee that's southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands with 40 mile per hour winds on a westerly course at 12 miles per hour. And I'll show you the National Hurricane Center forecast track on that as well. Here is Jose also, and you can see Jose, that loop that it made several days ago out in the Atlantic. There's a current position with those 80 mile per hour winds. It's going to hold on to that Category 1 status as it makes its way just east of Norfolk, Virginia on Tuesday morning, then up towards the New York, Boston area. Notice that New York and Boston within the area of uncertainty. So if you are headed in this direction, you're going to want to keep very close track of this storm over the next several days. And then it's eventually going to make its way out into the North Atlantic and die out over some much cooler water. Here is what the European model says this storm is going to do, a path very similar to the National Hurricane Center forecast track, taking it east of Norfolk, Virginia, then up towards the New York, Boston area, and then out over the North Atlantic where it's going to eventually die out. Now, we also have that area, that potential tropical cyclone that is out in the Atlantic, and it's taking a path, looks like, that's very similar to Irma over the next several days, taking it over towards Puerto Rico, Hispaniola, and towards the Turks and Caicos. And here's what the American model says this storm is going to do over the next several days. A very bad path for an area that was hit very hard by Irma, about to get hit very hard again Tuesday into Wednesday into Thursday of next week over Puerto Rico into Hispaniola, Turks and Caicos, and then eventually making its way in the next 7 to 10 days into the Carolinas. So definitely something that we're going to follow very, very closely. Here's a look at Tropical Storm Lee, which is just southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands, the National Hurricane Center forecast track, at least over the next 5 days, keeping it out over the Atlantic and possibly turning it back into a remnant low over the next several days because conditions are becoming less favorable for any further development. So we're going to continue to follow Lee very closely as well. A lot of activity that we are following, and we'll keep you up to date. Thanks for logging on for your Saturday morning tropical weather update.